our song shall rise to thee. Holy, 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 merciful and mighty, God in three persons, blessed Trinity.
Be in the presence of the living God.
Oh, yeah.
the creator and sustainer of the universe.
Yeah.
Would you bow your head to me as we go to the throne of mercy this morning?
Yes.
Oh Lord our God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the only wise God that known to mankind,
yes.
He who sit high and look low,
yes.
Jehovah Jireh.
Yes.
Lord, we come this morning,
yes.
To bow our head and Lord God, knowing that what has been for you on our side,
mm-hmm.
Lord, don't tell what we might be.
Yes.
You've been good to us.
Yes, sir.
You brought us from a mighty long way. You kept us alive enough to make it to the service just one more time. Lord God, thank you so much. Some didn't make it this way.
Yes.
But you saw fit, Lord God.
Yes.
You gave us another chance just to worship and preach. And Lord God, we come this morning to lift the name of on high.
Yes.
We come to give you the high praise. Hallelujah, Lord God. You worthy to be praised.
Yeah. Yeah.
You worthy, Lord. There's no God in heaven in earth. You know, be compared to you.
Yeah.
Lord God, you be good to us.
Yeah.
You protect us when we couldn't protect ourselves.
Yeah.
Lord God, thank you for answering our prayer. Thank you for watching our home. Lord, you shield us, you protect us from the Bible.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
You.
Lord God, we know we can't do it alone.
Yes.
We can't make it through this week without you, Lord.
Yes.
Lord, you promise us that you will never leave us nor forsake us.
Yes.
So Lord God, our feet, lead us on this week, Lord.
Yes.
Lead us to another week, Lord.
Yes.
Lord God, if you lead us,
yes.
We cannot shame.
Yes.
Lead us. Touch us this morning.
Yes,
because Lord, we need you.
Yes.
We need to hear a word from you. Lord, the president don't have the word.
Well,
Sunday don't have the word.
Yes.
But Lord God, we know your word is true.
Yes.
We know your word is the lamp of our feet.
Oh, yes.
So Lord God, speak to us.
Please.
Speak to our heart.
Please.
Lord God, bless the bishop.
Yes.
As he comes forward with the message.
Yes.
Lord, when we look up, we won't see him.
Yes.
But we see your spirit.
Yes.
We thank you and we praise you. In Jesus' name we pray. We grieve our sins. Amen.
Amen.
Our scripture lesson will be found in the book of Acts. Acts the second chapter. Verse 1 through 7. I'll be reading from the NIV verse this morning. On the day of Pentecost, 7 weeks after Jesus' resurrection, the believers were meet together in one place. Certain there was a sound from heaven, like the roar of a mighty windstorm in the sky above them. And it filled the house where they was meet. Then what looked like a flame or tongue of fire appeared and set on each of them. Everyone present was filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages. And the Holy Spirit gave them this ability. God and Jews from many nations were living in Jerusalem at that time. When they heard this sound, they came running to see what it was all about. And they were bewitched to hear their own language being spoken by the believer. They were beside themselves with wonder. How can this be? They exclaimed, these people are all from Galilee. May God will bless you and keep you until we meet again. Amen.
Thank you. Brothers and sisters all, this is our fine opportunity today to share Pentecost Sunday, the spirit birth of the church.
Amen.
And how glad we are on this Sunday to have this opportunity to invite the chief pastor of the 9th Episcopal District in the person of Bishop Harry Lee Seawright, who is also the president of the Bishop's Council. We thank God for our chief pastor, who has been very busy throughout the state conducting the work of the church, and not only in this Episcopal District, but throughout the connection. His word calls him near and far to satisfy the leadership of the denomination. We are very glad this morning that Grant Church here in Birmingham has the opportunity to welcome the chief pastor. We thank God for the word that he will bring in season, that it will meet us at the point of our need. We thank God that here now, the quadrennium is not over yet, but we thank God that a strong word from our chief pastor concerning the birth of the church in the Holy Spirit is ours to enjoy here at Grant, and because it is shared in this method, many others will have an opportunity to share. We ask that God will bless each of us, that our ears will be open, that we will come to the door of our tent, sit there, and listen for the word of God as the man of God speaks and expounds on the word of God. We look for that blessing in preachment. After we shall hear a musical interlude, one of the sage hymns of the church, the next voice you will hear will be that of Bishop Harry Lee Seawright, the chief pastor of the 9th Episcopal District, which comprises the entire state of Alabama. Hear ye him.
Amen.
Nathan, thank you for the privilege of being able to bring the word to you this morning. On this Pentecost Sunday, May 31st, 2020, it is with anticipation and with joy that we have been looking forward to this grand day, the day when we celebrate the birth of the Holy Spirit to the church, the day we celebrate Pentecost Sunday. I want to thank you for allowing me this privilege to share on this day when we celebrate the birth of the church. My God, how we have been looking at this day with anticipation, expectation, just as much as we were looking forward to the resurrection. And now we celebrate the day that the Holy Spirit was birthed upon the church. And so as I come this day, to all of those who are tuning in, I want to call your attention to St. John, the 16th chapter. And I want to call your attention starting at the 13th verse. Howbeit, when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth. For he shall not speak of himself, but who whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak, and he will show you things to come. He shall glorify me, for he shall receive of mine and shall show it unto you. All things that the Father has are mine, therefore I say that he shall take of mine and shall show it unto you. A little while, and you shall not see me, and again a little while, and you shall see me, because I go to the Father. This day, I want to talk about the advocate. The advocate. Praise the Lord. When Jesus Christ was preparing to leave this world, he gathered his disciples together. It was hard for them to understand their Savior leaving them. It was hard for them to comprehend the fact that Jesus, we have given up everything to be with you. We have left homes, families. We have left our arts. We have left our jobs. We have left everything to follow you and to be your disciples. And now you come telling us that you are getting ready to leave us. Jesus, we can't even comprehend it. Now, we heard what you said. You said, let not your hearts be troubled, and that you believe in me, believe also in my Father. For I'm going to my Father to prepare a place for you, that where I am, you may be there also. But Jesus, this is something that's hard for us to comprehend. We can't imagine life without you. We've been with you for these 3 years. How in the world are we going to do all of the miracles that we saw you perform and keep doing the work of what you call your Father who is in heaven? But Jesus wanted to give them assurance. Look, I am going away, but I am also going to leave you a helper. I'm going to leave you a comforter. I'm going to leave somebody that will be with you at all times. Someone who will lead you into all truth. Someone who will speak to your hearts and to your minds. Somebody who will give you comfort. Somebody who will give you strength. In other words, I'm going to send you an advocate. I'm going to send you someone who will stand on your side. Somebody who will be strength and hope and assurances to you as you go forward. And so, therefore, we come to celebrate that power. We come to celebrate that helper. Yes, I call him an advocate, because life can send us some ups and some downs. Life can send us much sorrow and pain. But if we didn't have a helper, if we didn't have Jesus the Christ, if we didn't have the power of the Holy Spirit working in us and outside of us, there's just no way we can make it. Let me just for a few moments look at the many ways that the Holy Spirit leads us. It is a wonderful thing to feel the guidance of the Spirit of God. It's a wonderful thing to feel that he is leading us to all truth. Have you ever been in a situation where you didn't know what to say? You didn't know how you were going to get through it? But because of the power of the Holy Spirit, he gave you the inspiration that you needed in order to make it. Isn't it amazing how he led you to come in contact with the right people or to receive the right kind of word for the encouragement that you needed? A song on the radio, or just a scripture that was refreshed in your mind from your Bible reading? Isn't it amazing how the Holy Spirit works in our lives to help us to get through situations? How he will send somebody in our lives at the right time to speak that word of truth, to speak that rhema word that brings us hope and assurances, that gives us the enthusiasm, that gives us the ability to say, I'm going to keep on stepping. I'm going to keep on doing this. I'm going to keep on keeping faith. We thank God for the advocate who knows our every need. I love the scripture that says he knows the number of hairs upon our head, our thoughts even before we think them. He knows our going out and our coming in. And then I love what the 139th Psalm said, even before we were in our mother's womb, he knew us. He knit us in the wombs. He fearfully and wonderfully made us. We are in his sight. We're the apple of his eye. We are the one whom he proclaimed that this is my child, whom I'm well pleased with. So as we come today, thank God for this advocate. Thank God for this advocate standing up on our behalf. An advocate is someone who goes with us and speaks for us and give the assurances that we are not in this by ourselves. In the Gospel of Matthew, the 20th chapter, he says, go ye into all the world and teach and baptize. And lo, I am with you always to the end of the earth. One thing that I have learned about our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ is that he is more than able to back up what he said. He is able to bring to light everything that he proclaimed that he wants to do for us. There is nothing like feeling the presence and the power of God with us wherever we go. I never ever think of myself as being alone anymore because I know that he is always with me. I always got an advocate. I always got a friend who is here with me, sticking closer than a very own brother. Look what the scripture says. He helps us to bring honor and glory to God. Anyone serious about their commitment knows that we are most inadequate to do the work of Christ. We are never good enough in our own sight. We are never capable of doing all that Christ would have us to do. And yet, thank God, he does not call us according to our abilities, but he calls us according to our availability. He calls us according to our obedience. He calls us unto our willingness to do his blessed will. I am so glad that the Holy Spirit is the power within us that enables us to do all the things that we need to do. Thank God for that Spirit that says, hey, look, I am going to put my super in front of your natural. I am going to give you the supernatural strength to speak and to verbalize all that I want my people to hear. Because I have designed and called you to give honor and glory to my Father who is in heaven. I've called you not to live no longer for yourself, but to live for the one who has called us from darkness into the marvelous light. I praise God for the fact that he does not want us to try to use our own powers. Our own powers won't get us nowhere. But when we yield to the Holy Spirit, when we say, Holy Spirit, have your way, come on into my life, come into my heart, it is then that the Holy Spirit has the right and wants the right to come in and regenerate, renew, and rebuild us so that we can become the proper instruments according to his divine will. Thank God that he is willing to use you and I. And when he uses us, thank you, Jesus, when he uses us, it's no secret what God can do. No wonder little John 5 says, greater is he that is within us than he that is within the world. Greater, hallelujah. This is why Jesus says, greater things shall you do than I have done because I go back to my Father. But therefore, our Father is glorified by the manner in which we allow God to use us. Thank God he wants to use us in spite of us, not because of us. I don't want nobody to ever feel that you are too bad off that you can't be used by God. Don't ever think that you are so inadequate that you cannot be used by God. God will supercharge you, my brothers. He will supercharge you, my sisters. And the thing about God, you're never too old or young to be used by God, whatever your background might be. God is willing and able to do what needs to be done to help you and to bring you out. When I think of God, I always like to use the phrase like the what I bought my children a toy once. And it was called a transformer. And you could take it and make it into different things. And one of the things that you could do was that you could stand it up and it looked something like a little man. And no matter what happened, No matter how much you threw blows at that little man, the little man just kept on popping up. Every time you knock him down, he would pop right back up. And so I began to explain to the children the reason the little man keeps on popping up is because he has a strong base. There is something in the bottom of the tube that when he is knocked down, he bounces back up because of the foundation that's built inside. And so that's why we keep on going. That's why we keep on praying. That's why we won't give up. That's why we keep faith. That's why we keep on praying. That's why we keep on believing. We believe in the possibilities of God. And all of this is done by faith. And let's remember that when we go forth, we got to have faith. We got to believe God. We got to know that God is on our side. We got to know that without faith, it is impossible to please him. And we who believe must believe that God is, and that he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. We got to believe that faith is the substance of things hoped for, and that it's the evidence of things not seen. We got to believe that we are covered by the armor of God. We got to believe that no weapon formed against us shall prosper, and every tongue that rises against us in judgment, we shall condemn. We got to believe that our weapons are not carnal, but they are mighty for the pulling down of strongholds. We got to keep on praying. We got to keep on trusting God. We got to keep on turning our lives over to God on a daily basis and letting God know we can't do this on our own. But God, we can do all things through you who gives us strength. So today, I just stopped by Grant AME Church. I stopped by to tell you on Pentecost Sunday, let's celebrate our power. Let's celebrate what God means to us. Let's celebrate the coming of the Holy Spirit. Let's celebrate our advocate. Let's celebrate all that God has done for us through the power of the Holy Spirit. For indeed we serve an awesome God, a holy God. And I just want to tell anybody, if you are contemplating giving your life to Jesus, do it today. If you are contemplating whether it's worth it, I can assure you that it's worth it. Will it be easy? No, it will not be easy. No, you will not have glorious days all the time. But I can assure you of this one thing, that when you make a commitment to Jesus, he'll be with you through the thick and the thin. He'll be right there for you in your darkest moments. He'll be right there when everybody else has given up on you. He will revive your soul. He will teach you. He will bless you. He will give you all that you stand in need of, because he is that kind of God. He is more than able. Lord, I thank God today that he is more than able, that whatever you come through, he'll bring you through. Whatever he takes you to, he is more than able to bring you out of it. Thank you, Lord. Whether it's sorrow, the loss of a loved one, whether it's financial difficulties, whether it's sorrow or pain, whatever it is, God is right here, willing and able to bring us out and to bring us through. I want you to know today that I love you. I praise God for you. Once again, to the pastor, Dr. Nathan, to the officers, to the members and the friends, the ministerial staff, all of the leadership, the membership, thank you for giving me this opportunity to share with you this day on Pentecost Sunday. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May heaven keep on smiling upon you. Amen.
How we thank God for a strong word preached in season for us here in Grant Church. We are the better for the voice of God's heralding message brought to us by our bishop today. We pray that you have been blessed, inspired to live and walk in the Spirit, and do not fulfill the flesh. We pray that God will bless us where we live in this week which is ahead of us. Pray that you will keep your ears tuned to the news and announcements that will be ours, shared often at the end of our service, and you may hear some throughout the week, which is ahead of us. Beloved, we stand now on the dawn of another month. The month of June is now standing in the shadow, and we pray that God will be waiting there with healing for the nation, and that we will all be made better. We want to say that Grant is greater in God because our chief pastor came this way. And so we thank God for Bishop Seawright. Pray that God will bless and order his steps as he governs the work of the church in the 9th Episcopal District. Shall we go forth? Praise God from whom all blessings flow.